If you like our video, please hit the like button and hit subscribe. Please hit the bell icon so you are notified when we come out with our new videos. If anyone has UFO footage they would share, we would love to see it, and maybe we will put it in OOF. All the alien claims and theories out there, the ones that speak of an alien-human hybrid agenda might be the most outlandish. However, many people do make these claims to the world, and although they themselves sometimes note how crazy they sound, they insist that what they're saying is real. While it is hard for even the most enthusiastic ufologist or alien researcher to take these statements entirely seriously, they are still very interesting ideas. 10. The body in the Cairn, July 2015, the story of a supposed alien hybrid government agent, who had been found decomposing in a car, appeared on several online media outlets. The man, who was eventually identified as Jeffrey Allen Lash, was found with over 1,000 guns, as well as other weapons such as knives, machetes, and a bow and arrows. He also had 7 tons of ammunition and cash amounting to $230,000. In addition to the car, he was discovered in, which was designed to be able to drive underwater, no less. He also owned 14 other vehicles. His fiancée, Catherine Nebron, made the off-the-wall announcement of his otherworldly origin through her attorney shortly after his death. She stated that Lash had confided in her several weeks before he died that he was working undercover for several unnamed government agencies. He had left Catherine with instructions to leave his body in the car when he died, and that government agencies would come to retrieve it. Initial background checks on Lash didn't uncover any sign of criminal activity on his part, and investigators didn't suspect that he had been the victim of foul play. According to Lebron, he had begun to experience difficulty breathing, but he'd refused to let her call for medical assistance in the hours before his death. 9. Born in a petri dish. It wasn't until Cynthia Crawford was in her 30s that her father revealed to her that she was the result of a top-secret government program. She was, her father informed her, an alien-human hybrid created in a petri dish, and that as well as carrying human DNA, she had the DNA of 2 different alien races as part of her genetic makeup. She claimed that she had encountered what she believed to be alien abductions many times throughout her life, which included medical procedures and impregnation, but that she now realized these experiences were more likely part of the program. She was told by her father that, as a child, she was taken in the middle of the night to an underground military facility. There, she was regularly tested and examined by government agents. Despite the many doubters to her story, no DNA testing has been volunteered by Crawford to confirm her claims. She is a regular speaker at numerous UFO and alien seminars across the United States. 8. Miguel Mendonca's proof of alien hybrids. Miguel Mendonca is a leading expert on green energy and renewable power sources. He is also convinced that aliens are in the process of helping humans evolve into higher beings by implanting their DNA into pregnant women around the Earth. Mendonca, from Bristol, England, co-authored the book Meet the Hybrids, The Lives and Missions of ET Ambassadors on Earth with respected and experienced UFO researcher, Barbara Lamb. In the book, he claims to have met several alien hybrids, all of whom state they are involved in a mission that will improve the human race. Mendonca claims that DNA testing would be of little use to help prove his claims, as only human DNA would be detected and anything else would simply be ignored. He also stated that the hybrids themselves are against their DNA being taken for fear that governments would use it to create super soldiers that would be utilized by the military. Mendonca stated that he went into the project with an open mind, but that he can feel the energy of the hybrids when he speaks with them and is convinced of their authenticity. He also states that he is very much an academic, and has to be sure of his facts. He believes this is why there are so many UFO sightings and that the hybrid agenda is the reason they are coming to Earth. 7. Celtic genes. According to Hillary Porter, who says she has been abducted many times herself by aliens, extraterrestrials are specifically targeting people of Celtic descent to install an alien hybrid program. Porter is an experienced ufologist who is a regular speaker at UFO seminars. She even believes that one stretch of road in particular, between Swansea and Cardiff in Wales, is a hot spot for UFO activity. Not only this, she says that the government is fully aware of what is happening, but they are powerless to stop it. Porter believes that aliens are targeting people of Celtic descent as they feel their genes are better suited for creating a human-alien hybrid race, which she says is their ultimate goal. Porter has conducted extensive research for over 4 decades, which has led her to conclude that the alien hybrid agenda is very real. She also states that this agenda is not for the good of mankind, as many who make similar claims say it is. She says that although she and others have recalled pleasant memories from their experiences, this is nothing more than a cover, or false memory implanted by the aliens themselves to hide the horrific events. 6. Jujualui Kuida. Star being author and ufologist Jujualui Kuida claims to have had extraterrestrial experiences since she was 5 years old, and has since awakened to her ET identity. In 2010, she published the book We Are Among You Already, which told of how aliens were incarnating and creating alien-human hybrids right here on Earth. She also founded the East Bay UFO Contact Group the same year. Kia states that she is a star being who chose to incarnate on Earth as a human being. Some are said to choose to do so as animals. According to Kuida, Mother Earth sent out a signal for help into the cosmos many decades ago. She further claims that she originates from the planet Faki, which she says is in the Andromeda Galaxy, and that her people are called Phagians. Kuida believes her mission is to assist in awakening other star beings and ultimately raise the vibration of planet Earth, which she says is being monitored by countless beings throughout the cosmos. 5. The Indigo Children. There are claims of Indigo Children or Star Children, extremely intelligent and highly sensitive children, all over the world. While these are most likely just normal children who happen to have extremely high intelligence for their young ages, some claim that they are the result of genetic engineering. 2 cases, in particular, appear to stand out. Jason Andrews's first alien experience occurred on his 4th birthday in Kent, England, in 1987. As a violent storm proceeded to sweep over the area, Jason apparently began to mutter a series of numbers, seemingly in a trance-like state. As the storm took hold, the house the Andrews family lived in began to shake until Jason turned to his parents and calmly stated to them, "They are waiting for me, I have to go." The 4-year-old boy then went to exit the property before his father wrestled him away from the front door. As suddenly as it had begun, the shaking of the house and the storm ceased, and Jason returned to his normal self. The family appeared to forget about the incident until 8 years later, when Jason informed them that since that day, he had been abducted by strange beings that would come into his room and take him to some kind of operating table. His mother, Anne Andrews, along with UFO researcher and author Jean Ritchie, concluded that Jason was an indigo child, and this was the reason that the aliens had an interest in him. Jason himself, now in his 30s, states that he does have certain psychic and spiritual abilities. Nikki Patillo claims that her daughter, Maddie, is also an indigo child who has claimed several times to her that her home is in the sky. Patillo claims Maddie has developed and shown otherworldly abilities, and she firmly believes that the girl carries alien DNA within her body. Patillo wrote a book about her experiences titled Children of the Stars and stated that her daughter and many other alleged star children are the incarnations of spirits that have been sent to Earth from all over the universe for the benefit of the human race. 4. Hybrid Children and Alien Fathers. In January 2016, a story circulated on the internet regarding 2 young ladies who claimed they were mothers to multiple alien hybrid children. Bridget Nielsen from Sedona and Aluna Verse from Los Angeles both claim to be just 2 of many women who were part of the hybridization program. Bridget claims to have 10 alien hybrid children, while Aluna says that she has 3 otherworldly offspring. They claim that at the moment, their children are in a state of suspended childhood and live with their fathers on board huge spaceships. They hope that one day they can set up a community somewhere far from the city for themselves and other mothers of hybrid children. This they believe will allow their cosmic children to feel safe enough to visit them on Earth. The aim of the hybridization program, according to Bridget, is to create a super being with the best of the genes from humans and aliens alike. Bridget claims to be in regular contact with all 10 of her children and says that hundreds of women around the world are mothers to hybrid children but simply do not realize it. 3. David Jacobs. David Jacobs taught American history for over 30 years at Temple University. He also recently claimed that aliens had likely been abducting human beings for centuries to create alien-human hybrids who not only walk among us right now but are poised to take over the world. Jacobs is now the director at the International Center for Abduction Research and has conducted interviews and studies of over 150 abductees. He has also released several well-written and well-received books to make his argument to the wider public, all of which have been published by respected publishers. He states that abductees, albeit under hypnosis, more often than not recall the same obscure details. They all speak of either human-like or insect-like aliens that appear to have a need to breed. Many female abductees frequently speak of being impregnated before having the fetus removed surgically, and then being forced to nurse the infant. He also reports that at the time of the alleged abductions, the person is usually genuinely physically missing, with many loved ones reporting the person missing before they suddenly reappear again. Jacobs said recently that his work will either be an interesting but non-essential footnote, or that it will prove to be the most important thing that's ever happened to humankind. He says that he suspects that the aliens' actions are for their benefit and not for ours. 2. Hybrids created by reptilians. Alien abductee and UFO researcher James Bartley recently made available online an interview he had conducted with a fellow abductee who had been sent to him by experienced researcher Barbara Berthalic. In the transcript, the abductee is referred to as PR, to protect his identity. PR told of his close-up experience with alien-human hybrids, who he said is a creation of the reptilians. Their main goal was to harvest the life force from humans. Following the interview with PR, Bartley concluded that there are three types of alien hybrids on Earth. There are alien abductees who have had their genetic makeup altered by their abductors. There are half-gray, half-human alien hybrids that are, according to Bartley, mostly present during abductions. And then some hybrids appear for the most part as normal human beings. It is this last type of hybrids that the reptilians have placed in positions of power around the world. Coincidentally or not, this last claim of hybrids is very much in line with author David Icke, who has made similar claims of reptilian hybrid aliens for the last two decades. 1. Eddie Page and the Secret Experiment. Eddie Page, half Pleiadian. Watch this video on YouTube after years of confusion that included being arrested as a defector during a tour of Vietnam when he went missing for 11 days, a broken first marriage, and discovering he was adopted. Eddie Page finally discovered the truth about his existence. He was the product of a top-secret government experiment to produce an alien hybrid. According to Page, his father is actually an alien from the Pleiades star system. He even claims that his official military documents state that he is not of human origin. The Page states that from 1953 to 1955, there were experiments carried out on U.S. citizens by aliens in exchange for providing alien technology to the U.S. government. He made the discoveries after he agreed to be hypnotically regressed. He recalled that the missing days he experienced in Vietnam were due to him being wounded on the mission he was on and consequently being taken by aliens and patched up, before being returned to Earth, 800 kilometers, 500 miles, away from where he should have been. The rest of his unit died, and he has no doubt he would have died also if it hadn't have been for their intervention. The Page further discovered that he was one of 32 clones who were part of the experiment, a total of 21 female clones and 11, including Page, male clones. According to his research, only 8 of those clones still alive, of which he is the only male.